One teaspoon of soil contains more living organisms than there are people in the world. Soil animals represent nearly 25% of the total diversity of all known living organisms. Many factors can damage that life, like pesticides, herbicides, oversaturation, and tilling. The ecosystem requires a delicate balance in order to maintain an adequate environment for crops. Too many or too few of any organism can have a damaging chain reaction or can simply cost the farmer money for things like fertilizer. To demonstrate this harmonious system, we must travel deep into the dirt to find the tiniest of creatures. Protozoa are single-celled organisms living inside water films in shallow and deep soil. They eat bacteria, fungi, and algae, decomposing and cycling nutrients. Also within the water films are rotifers and tardigrades, which are both predators and scavengers. One of their favorite foods is nematodes, omnivorous transparent worms that live in water and the soil and move bacteria through soil layers. Earthworms live throughout the soil, burrowing, aerating the soil, and helping make nutrients more accessible for the plants.
So here's a fun, weird worm fact for you. So if you can manage to develop a million of these per acre, which if you take a scoop from a shovel like this, that's roughly a foot of soil, all right? So if you can get 15 of those in a scoop, which right now we're looking at one, I mean, they could be deeper, we could just have one, I don't know. But if you can manage to get 15, they can cycle 35 tons of soil. And what I mean is they can eat it and then poop it out. And the nutrient analysis of that casting is, it's real rich in plant essential nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, you know. So if you can foster these guys and get them going, what do you need to buy fertilizer for? You know, the soil is awash in nutrients. We just got to figure out how to make them, get them in a plant usable form. And that's all done through cycling with microbiology and stuff like earthworms.
Then there are mites and springtails crawling throughout the soil, crucial in the decomposition process. Scurrying along the top or in the upper layer of the soil are the millipedes, particularly important for plant decomposition. Then come the larger predators, like centipedes, spiders, fireflies, soldier beetles, and ground beetles. These troops are the pest control. Coming from above, there are the well-known decomposers, flies such as these flower flies. Let's not forget our other cleanup crews, burying beetles and ants, removing animal carcasses from the soil. Then there are the glorious dung beetles, of which there are 64 known species in Arkansas. They do the hard work of decomposing fecal material and reducing the spread of food pathogens. While there are many more organisms, we will end with these, ground nesting bees. They live in the soil and are crucial for pollination. Tilling the soil, leaving it bare, and wasteful watering practices can destroy this ecosystem.